welcome to tonight's contest, where the RHS Lady Z's take on the TVHS Lady Vikings, brought to you in part by Shepherd Chevrolet in Rochester.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
The ball is up in the center circle, and the tip controlled by Tippecanoe Valley. Teal runs the point, now gives to Tucker, high on the right side. Rochester starts.
Man-to-man.
No. I don't think so, Brad. I think this is like a triangle and two. Backdoor pass is knocked away, but picked up right there by Ball. She throws up a shot, no good. And Stasiak with the rebound. I think it was a triangle and two. Rochester started defensively in. Stasiak in the lane. Dumps down low to Pollock. Has her shot blocked by Seacrest. Ball is loose and four. X comes out of there with it. Her dump pass is taken away by Teal and Tippecanoe Valley. Teal now gives to Tucker. She'll cross the timeline left for the Lady Vikings. Now middle of the floor. Sets up shot between the rings. Works the left side to Teal. Teal, couple of dribbles at the elbow in the paint, gives to Seacrest. She drives the basket, throws up a five-footer, it goes. Tippecanoe Valley strikes first, it's 2-0, with 7 minutes to play in the first quarter. Tippecanoe Valley, and looks like in a man-to-man defense, as Becky Malko has had three really good games here all of a sudden for Rochester, gives to Eck Holland left wing. Holland wraparound pass into double team. Somehow Stasiak got it, dumps down to B. Her jumper is good.
Nice job by Stasiak. She's back in the game. For the Lady Zebras, she managed to clear herself a space down low and make the wraparound pass to Pollock, who's wide open on the opposite block.
We're tied at two. Teal with it, gives out to Tucker, high on the left side for Tippecanoe Valley, who drives it right at the elbow, cut off by the defense on the baseline to Ball. Ball left side to Teal. Teal with the basketball right in front of the student section, drives it into the paint, kicks it out to Seacrest, who gives in the corner to Tucker, and that makes it Hoffman, loses it out of bounds, and Rochester going to get it back. Nice defense right now by Rochester here, a minute and a half into the game. We're tied at two. The Lady Zebras with the basketball going to our left. And Becky Malko will bring it up the floor. And against the half-court trap, splits a double team. Works into the paint, gives down low to Stasiak. Layup is good. 4-2. Rochester on top.
And you could definitely tell that was something that they've drawn up and practiced this week, because Stasiak came from the far corner.
Teal's jumper in the lane is good, and we're tied at four. You know, last trip down the floor for Rochester, Becky Malko, there wasn't even a hesitation. She was splitting the double team and going to the paint.
Right.
Pollock down low again. She's fouled on a shot by Seacrest. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
That's the first foul of the game coming against Seacrest.
5:55 to play. First quarter, we're tied at four. And B. Pollock will go to the line to shoot two for the Lady Zebras.
Well, no hesitation on Malko. She drove, like you mentioned, drove down through the lane, but Stasiak, too, cleared out, giving her that space, and then as she got bottled up by the defense, she came cutting back
right
on the baseline, wide open for the layup.
B. Pollock connects on her first free throw. She'll have one more. Rochester back up by one, and the senior will have one more free before Rochester. Pollock ready, eyes the second one, lets it fly, and it's good again. Rochester back up, 6-4, and Valley on the run. Tucker through the center circle. X will pick her up at the top of the key. Tucker works left side to Teal.
That's a man-to-man defense.
You're right. It is now. You're exactly right. Teal to Ball. Ball about 18 feet away. One dribble gives back door to Tucker. Throws the shot over from Pollock. No good. X with the rebound. Holland runs for Rochester. Valley with the numbers. Holland accelerates to the baseline. Loses the handle. Teal steals it. Teal the basketball for Valley. Now Valley with the numbers. Middle of the floor, and she double dribbles and kicks it and travels. And yeah, regardless, going to give it back to Rochester.
Safe to say she lost the handle on it.
5:27 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 6-4, and the Lady Zebras will have it back. Malko will bring it up the floor, walks it right through the center circle, out the volleyball line, and works down left side of the floor. Throws up a shot off the window, no good. Tough shot, Seacrest with the rebound. Clears herself, now gives off, and her pass is stolen. Malko's layup is good.
Becky Malko just waiting in transition for that pass. She knew it was coming back.
8-4, Rochester. 5 minutes to play, first quarter. Tucker backs away in through the three-point line, down low to wide open Teal. Teal hesitates, runs around Pollock, throws up a tough shot, rebound by Stasiak. Keaton, one dribble, now gives to Murphy. Murph will bring it up the floor. Murph works to the left wing, looking down low to Keaton. Has her on the block. Keaton backs her way in, throws up a shot. Tough shot, a lot of contact, no foul. Rebound to Hoffman. Hoffman pushes to our right. Rochester up by four. Hoffman in the paint, stops, pops, nope. Rebound Murphy. Rochester runs. 4.5 to play first quarter, and from Coach Stasiak, they slow it down just a bit. X, a long three, right wing, good!
Oh! Lexa Holland from 3 steps behind the arc.
And tipping into Valley will take a 30-second timeout. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:24 to play in the first quarter. Rochester out to an 11-4 lead, and Rochester applying some man-to-man pressure in the backcourt as the inbound pass comes in to Teal, who gives off to Tucker. She'll take X right through the center circle in the man-to-man, the 1-3-1 zone now. Teal around the defense, at the elbow left, gives to Tucker. Tucker backs it out.
Still man-to-man.
Boy, it looked like a 1-3-1, didn't it?
Well, you got Pollock playing off her man because they're clear out by the arc.
And the defense forces a turnover. Rochester going to get it back.
Pollock's not going to follow Kelsey Bell out the three-point line. She's just going to stay in the paint.
Yeah. Yeah, she should.
Yeah, that's where Bell's going to hurt you, is in the paint.
Rochester up by 7. 4 to play in the first quarter. Holland and Rochester makes their way to the right wing, 5 feet behind the arc, gives it top to Murph.
That's where she made the last shot.
Chuck it again. Murphy backs it out and resets the volleyball line. Works away in the lane. Jump pass down low, taken away by Segrist, and Segrist runs for Valley.
Murphy should have shot it.
To Hoffman now on the near side. Hoffman works against Malcolm in the man-to-man defense. 3 on the white ring, is in and out, no good. Rebound tipped around it. X comes out of the with it. Ball's loose now. Now Valley has it. Hoffman again for 3. Nope, in and out again. Tucker, the putback is no good. Rebound fought for, and ball comes out of the with it. Out to Hoffman. She penetrates, and her pass is stolen by X. Egg elects a hollow, left side of the floor. Goes to the basket, foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot 2. Wow, there's a lot of action right there on that possession. Alexa Holland will go to the line to shoot 2 for Rochester, leading by 7 with 3:19 to play in the first quarter.
And Tucker's first foul, team second.
Exit the line, just hit a three-pointer, a big three-pointer just moments ago. The first one goes for the sophomore. She'll have one more.
And at the other end, was it Hoffman? Two of them. Threes that went down.
Both
bounced in the rim and came back
both
out.
Both of them were down and came back out. Bailey Abbott comes into the game for the first time, and Amalco sits for Rochester. X's second one, no good, and the rebound to ball. 12-4, Rochester by 8. Teal in the lane, dumps down to Segrist. Her jumper over Murphy is no good. Ball tipped around, and Abbott comes out of there with it. X now runs to our left. Holland. Outside to Murph, tough pass to handle. She picks it up on the bounce on the right wing. Cross court, throws it into the Valley bench, and it's a turnover. But, you know, when you're near a smaller team, it's really tough to throw it over the top of the defense.
Well, that's never an advisable pass. I don't think any coach wants you throwing it across the top of the defense. But that time, Murph expected somebody to be in a corner.
Yep.
There wasn't anybody there.
Teal, pull-up jumper over B is no good. Tucker with the rebound. Teal, down low to ball. Ball over Abbott. Jumper's good. And that breaks a long scoreless drought by the Tippecanoe Valley Lady Vikings and cuts to the Rochester lead in half at 12-6. 2:35 to play in the first quarter. Rochester the basketball again going to our left. Murphy top of the key. And a man defense by the Lady Vikings. X, 3, right corner. Nope. And the rebound fought for. Teal comes out of there with it. I'm impressed by her jumping ability. She gets off the ground. And then Teal's pass is taken away. It's loose. It's still loose. Goes out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Tippecanoe Valley. And Rochester going to get it back. And coming into the game, look out, Meredith Broyette, a 5'8 freshman. And she is almost automatic from behind the arc.
Right, this freshman class, the Tippecanoe Valley, has got some talent.
Yeah, you're right. Just wait till you see next year's class. They're as good. I get to see them tomorrow.
Oh, good.
2:10 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 12-6. Holland, right side to Stasiak. Stasiak at the elbow. Cut off by the defense. Out to Ag. She'll fire another three. It's off the mark. No good. Hoffman at the rebound and runs for Tippecanoe Valley. And then has it taken away by Holland. Stasiak. And then Stasiak is fouled by Sechrist. And I believe that is Sechrist's second.
Yes.
Ball just came out of the game. And I'm assuming.
Yeah, Sechrist may have to as well.
And ball is going to come back in. And Sechrist will come out.
Something the Lady Zebras need to be cautious of is, you know, taking the three-pointers. They seem to have had the green light here in the first quarter to do so.
Sure.
And you're going to have long rebounds when that happens. And Valley's the kind of team that can hurt you in transition.
You're right. They are pretty quick. Abbott swings to Murphy, top of the key, a minute 45 to play, first quarter, 12-6 Rochester. Murphy at the elbow, backs away into the paint. Cut off by the defense. Leaner on the way, off the glass, no good. Gets her own rebound, the putback is no good. Gets the rebound again, the putback is good.
Stay right in there and keep fighting.
14-6, lead is back to 8, 90 seconds to play, first quarter. Tucker will go all the way to the basket in the lane, kicks it out for a three by Broyette. It's good. Actually, does it just inside the arc.
She had a foot on the line.
And it's 14-8.
But
as 1:15.
Yeah, as you mentioned, automatic from 19 feet.
And now we have a reach-in foul coming against Tippecanoe Valley, so it'll be out of bounds to Rochester baseline right. Again, it's 1:15 to play in the first quarter. And Taylor Trapiti, a 5'5 junior, will come into the game, and she'll replace Tucker, who has two personal fouls.
Yep.
Holland will look to trigger it in. Baseline right for the Rochester Lady Zebras, who lead by 6 at 14-8. Gets it in to Abbott. Abbott in the lane. Shot partially blocked. Teal then is knocked down to the floor and out of bounds. They're not going to call a foul.
Yeah,
yep, they are going to call a foul. They'll call a foul on Bailey Abbott. Becky Malco comes back into the game, and X will sit down.
Well, Abbott will pick up her first. That's a team first for Rochester.
1:09 to play, first quarter. Rochester up 14-8, and the Lady Zebras in a full-court press. Hoffman runs away from the core full-court press. Works to the left elbow in the corner to Borayette. Her three is short. Rebound to Stasiak. Rochester runs with the numbers. Stasiak, right side of the floor, goes up for the shot. She's fouled on the shot by Teal. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Good heavens, she's just coming off a concussion. The last thing I told her was keep your head off the floor.
Yeah. Well, Teal about turned her upside down on that foul. That was definitely you're not getting a layup over me kind of foul.
So Keaton Stasiak in the line to shoot two with 56.2 to play in the first quarter. Keaton's first one on the way is in and out, no good. She'll have one more. Of course, Keaton has missed the last couple of games because of a concussion. First game back in a while. She'll have one more for the Lady Zebras, looking to push this lead back to 7. Keaton ready. Eyes the second one. Lets it fly. Good this time. 15-8 Rochester. 56 to play in the first quarter.
Tippecanoe Valley definitely trying to use their speed in the transition game.
And that speed just cost them a foul and a turnover.
Against Hoffman. That's her first.
She ran six. Over B. Pollock.
Yeah, she did. And you notice every time they bring that ball up, they're full speed ahead.
Yeah. As soon as they get their hands on it, it's full tilt. You're right. It didn't take them long to get the.
Well, for the most part, they're beating. Whoever's got the ball has beat 7 of the 10 players down the floor.
Yeah, you're right. And that time, it was the disadvantage.
Unfortunately, the other two were wearing white, and they were in front of her. So.
51.6 to play in the first quarter. Rochester by 7. And Becky Malco will cross the timeline. Man-to-man defense by the Tippecanoe Valley Lady Vikings. Malco works to the right side around Teal. Picks up her dribble. And it's going to be taken away by Teal. Now Tippecanoe Valley runs to our right. And then her pass is taken away by Holland. X runs away from Royette. X left side of the floor. And her pass is kicked away by Ball, who stopped the fast break with that kick. And it's going to stay with Rochester baseline left with 30 seconds to play in the first quarter as Carly Murphy comes back into the game and Becky Malco will come out again.
Well, Malco on that fast break come down the weak side with Holland, and unfortunately I think she might have gotten too deep, and Ball was able to stand between both Holland and Malco and kick that ball away.
Lob pass comes to Stasiak, deep in the lane, stops, rises up, the shot draws nothing but air, rebound to Ball, who gives the ball yet. Oh, that's a double dribble.
Yeah, and it got called. It was a little late on the call, but it got called.
Becky Malco come out, favoring that left leg a little. Did you notice that?
Yeah, I did.
22 seconds to play, first quarter. Rochester by 7, and probably will look for the final shot of the period, I would think. Of course, we thought that last time an X drained one from about 27 feet away. Holland, oh, there he comes again. Yeah. It's good again.
See, she's just been too close on those other ones.
18-8 Rochester, 7 seconds
well,
to play first quarter.
Trapedi guarding her. She was just giving her too much space.
Ball against, and then she travels. Good defense by B with 1.6 to play in the first quarter. Rochester by 10. Murphy will look to get it in. Now to X at the buzzer, three-quarter court. Not going to get there. After one, Rochester leads 18-8. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester is the place for all of your automotive service needs.
I've been coming to Shepherd's for service approximately 5 or 6 years. My husband drives the Honda 2004, I believe, so it isn't brand new. And he brings it here. We get our tires here, oil changes, whatever needs to be done, they take care of. We have a good history with the Shepherd family, so we're happy to come here.
Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, we go to the second quarter. Lady Zebras start with the basketball, up by 10. Murphy, crossover dribble, takes off into the paint. Cut off by the defense, out to Holland, who just hit a big three just moments ago. Holland behind her, back in the lane. Dump pass to Stasiak, out to Murphy. Fakes a three, drives the baseline. Has it knocked out of bounds by Valley. It'll stay with Rochester. You know, one thing that Coach Kendick told me in the pregame is why they lost in Northwood, or a big factor of why they lost in Northwood, is because they committed a ton of turnovers. They've already got 11 in this first quarter.
Yeah, they're going to have to take better care of the basketball, or Rochester is just going to take the game away from them.
Rochester and themselves have 5. I thought that was a lot for the first quarter. Malco in the paint, rises up, shot on the way, no good. Rebound to Teal, and taken away by Pollock. Her layup is good. 20-8. Rochester on top, 30 seconds gone in the second period. Trapedi just inside the arc, top of the key. Her jumper is good. Cuts the lead back to 10 for Rochester. Holland quickly up the floor. Right wing for the Lady Zebras.
I think she wanted to shoot it.
I think she thought about a three, but decided to pass it up, give to Murphy, now to Malco. Becky goes in the paint. A lot of contact. Ball out of bounds. It's going to be last touched by Teal and Tippecanoe Valley, and Rochester will keep possession. Bailey Abbott back into the game, and Pollock will sit down. 7:02 to play. Second quarter. Rochester up 20-10. Holland. Got to get it in over the defense to Malco. Fakes a three, drives it, loses it. Picked up by Hoffman. Hoffman goes to the basket. Fouled on the shot by Murphy, and she'll go to the line to shoot two.
That'll be Murphy's first, team second.
And I like this Carla Hoffman, or Kara Hoffman, a bigger pardon. Like we said before, she gets the basketball, and with one step, she is at full speed.
Yeah.
So Hoffman for Tippecanoe Valley at the line for two. First one's off the side of the iron. No good. She'll have one more. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 6:55 to play first half. Rochester up 20-10. And the senior, Kara Hoffman, at the line for one more for Tippecanoe Valley. Second one is on the way. No good again. And good rebound by Stasiak, who gives to Murphy. Murph walks it up against Hoffman for Tippecanoe Valley. And the bounce pass now to X. Crosses the timeline right. Holland right wing against Trapedi.
Trapedi playing a little tighter defense on
that. I would think that's what it was probably called for.
Yeah.
Malco, right side, picks up her dribble. Now to Stasiak at the free throw line, throws up the shot. It's good. Team Stasiak gives the Lady Zebras a 12-point lead at 22-10. And quickly up the floor is Hoffman. Hoffman outside to Broyette. Feeds down low to Ball. Ball in the paint. Takes Bailey Abbott to the rack. Her jumper's good. I think she really thought about kicking that out to the three-point shooter.
You're right, too. She looked.
Holland to Murphy. Murphy in the paint. Loses the handle in her footing. Picked up by Tippecanoe Valley. Hoffman in the paint. Her jumper on the way is good off the glass.
Number 20, Kara Hoffman.
Yeah, we're going to dry the floor off over here. Murphy stepped in some wetness on the floor.
And Murph comes out of the game. And back in is B. Pollock with 6 minutes to play in the first half. Rochester up 22-14. It'll be Rochester basketball on the far side going to our left. Still mouthing up some water down there on the Rochester's right side of the lane on the block. think we're ready. Here we go. Malco through the center circle. Gets a pick from Pollock. Right, runs right in the lane. Throws up a shot. Tough shot. No good. Rebound by Pollock. Her putback is good. I think took one right in the kisser.
Yeah, kind of an off-balance putback by Pollock, but it went.
Lead is back to 10 for Rochester. Teal in the paint. Stops. Kicks it outside to Broyette. Wide open three. Good.
That's somebody that cannot get wide open like that.
Rochester takes a 30-second timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Smith Farm Store in the Rochester Plaza is sending out New Year's wishes by inviting you to their New Year sales celebration. All Christmas decorations right now, 50% off. All toys, 40% off. Clothing and footwear, take 20% off. Right now, pick up a 50-pound bag of sunflower seed for only $19.59. Let the helpful staff at Smith Farm Store direct you to what you need for indoors and out. It's the Smith Farm Store New Year sales celebration, located at 161 Rochester Plaza.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
5.5 minutes to play in the first half. Rochester leading now 24-17 after Meredith Broyette's big three for Tippecanoe Valley. And as soon as that happened, Coach Stasiak went right to a timeout.
Yeah, Tippecanoe Valley's offense is starting to find their range and find their pace. Rochester's quick pace in the first quarter has kind of slowed off here in the second.
Well, I'm guessing that's one of the three people you could not lose track of was Broyette, and Rochester did because she was wide open.
And coming off the bench, I think Coach Stasiak wanted to make sure that his team knew that.
Bailey Abbott puts in a tough shot to push the lead back to 9 at 26-17. Teal to Trapedi. Trapedi with her foot on the line. Her jumper's good. 26-19, and now the baskets are falling about every time down the floor. Holland, top of the key, gives to Malco between the rings. 2-3 zone by Tippecanoe Valley.
No.
It's
a man.
Still man, yep. Okay. Malco, 10-footer left side, off the back of the iron, no good. Stasiak with the rebound, gives to Holland. X down low to B. Pollock against the double team, jumper is no good, too hard off the glass. Teal with the rebound and runs. Tippecanoe Valley running to our right. Heels cross court to Broyette in the corner to Trapedi. Trapedi, couple of dribbles. Broyette top of the key. Out of Teal. Teal tries to split the double team. Somehow picks up the loose ball. Her shot no good. Holland to the rebound. X runs it down to our left. Holland lob pass to a wide open Abbott. Her jumper is good. 28-19 Rochester. 4:15 to play in the first half.
That's a good look by Holland. They recognize Abbott. Didn't have anybody guarding her on the block.
Teal, Trapedi, put on the line again. Long jumper is short, and the rebound, the ball. Out for to Teal. Her 10-footer is good. Rochester really didn't have anybody that really wanted to grab that rebound, so Teal did and put it in for two. Under four to play, first half. The lead is down to 7. Rochester's leading the basketball. Holland to Malco, and we're going to have a legal screen on Keaton Stasiak.
I think Stasiak had been all right if she didn't move her feet.
Yep.
If she sets the screen and stays put. But the defense tried to go around the top of her, and Keaton tried to slide through it up a little higher to keep contact.
Murph back into the game, and Bailey Abbott have a rep. 3:45 to play. Yeah,
Got away with a carry, I think.
Ball against Murphy, short. Pollock with the board. B gives to Holland. Rochester runs with a 7-point lead. 3.5 to play first half. Left side to Malco. Becky, one dribble. Back to Holland. Back to Malco. She'll take a three. Left wing. In and out. No good. And the rebound fall for. We're going to have a foul coming against. Is that going to be Boyette? That's a foul? Yeah. B. Pollock gets up slow. Well, because she's wiping up the floor. And she'll go to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
That's on Pollock. That's their 7.
No. Yeah. No, not on Pollock.
That's her first. Team 7.
Oh, okay. Okay.
I don't know what I said. It could have been anything.
It's becoming that time of night. Pollock has 2, or one of the bonus. First one's good, and she'll have 1 more.
It's just water, really.
I didn't check it.
No, I know.
B with 1 more, looking to push this lead back to 9 with 3:22 to play in the first half. Pollock ready. Eyes the second one. Lets it go. And it's good again. I think B's about perfect from the line, isn't she?
She is about perfect.
30, 20.
If you could be about perfect.
30-21, Rochester leads, and on the entry pass, I think a foul committed by the Lady Zebras will be out of bounds at Tippecanoe Valley.
54, Carly Murphy. Checking back in with the Zebras number.
And Murph just picked up foul number two, so that's going to bring Bailey Abbott up off the bench and back into the game. Teal will look to get it in. Teal study. Bounce pass in to Trapedi. Back to Teal on the right baseline. Back to Trapedi. In the lane to Ball. Turnaround jumper. Nope. Good block out by B. Pollock. Gives it to Holland. Holland, right side of the floor for Rochester. Behind the arc. Picks it up. Gives it to Stasiak in the corner to Malco. Long three again. Off the back of the iron. Pollock the rebound. Her putback no good. Abbott, her putback is no good. Rebound fought for. B has it. Comes out of there with it. Puts it off the glass and no good. Abbott the rebound. She is fouled by Ball and she'll go to the line to shoot one in the bonus.
Good Lord, Abbott and Pollock doing a great job of working the opposite sides. One of them needs to make a layup.
So Bailey Abbott will be at the line to shoot one in the bonus with 2:49 to play in the first half. Rochester leading 30-21. Abbott ready. First one by the lefty is no good, but Pollock with a rebound. She puts off the glass and good. Rochester back up by double digits now.
Pollock and Abbott building their rebounding stats on that position.
Teal to the baseline. Pull-up jumper from 5 feet is good. Might want to stop her. 32-23. Rochester's lead and the ball, and Coach Stasiak will look to spread the floor and run some clock. 2:20 to play in the first half. Malco bounce pass to Holland. Holland a couple of dribbles against Hoffman. And out in the middle of the floor. She'll fire a long three. No good. Too hard. Abbott with a rebound. The Stasiak who gives it back to Holland. Holland. Her runner in the lane is good. Good heavens. 2 minutes to play. First half. Rochester by 11 for Petey. Gives to Hoffman. Hoffman left side. Inside the arc. Outside to Broyette. Broyette gives off to Hoffman. She drives, throws up a shot from 10 foot, no good. Broyette with the rebound, make that Pollock with the rebound. And now X has it. Holland through the center circle, works to the right side, a minute 40 to play in the first half. Rochester by 9. Make that Rochester by 11, and then Abbott loses a handle on the ball. It'll be tied up. Turnover Rochester. Valley going to get it back.
Abbott had a good look. It was a great job by Holland getting her the basketball. She just couldn't get a clean handle on the pass.
90 seconds to play, first half. Rochester by 11, a 34-23. Here comes a half-court trap. Teal around the defense to Trapedi. Trapedi back to Teal. Splits the defense in the paint. Down low, passes, goes out of bounds. Last touch by Valley. Trapedi trying to plead her case, saying it's touched by Rochester. But the official says nope. Give it back to the Lady Zebras with a minute 23 to play in the first half. So apparently, spread the floor means take the first three.
Means spread the floor, and when the defense backs off, shoot it. Yeah.
Holland between the rings. Bounce pass to Malco on the left wing. A minute 9 to play in the first half. Malco in the paint now. Splits the defense to Holland high on the right side. Now to Stasiak in the center circle. Stasiak, a couple of dribbles to the right. Cut off by the defense. Now to Malco with under a minute to play in the first half. Rochester up 34-23. Malco. Dumps down low to Pollock, outside to X, quick three, right wing, good!
There you go. She's got to be 22 feet away to get it.
37-23, 45 to play in the first half. Trapedi, right side, sends left side to Teal. Teal against Pollock, outside to Hoffman. Back to Trapedi. Trapedi, couple of dribbles against X, has her pocket picked, but right there's Broyette. Broyette runs around the defense. Now we're going to have a foul. Keaton Stasiak just picked up foul number two, and I guess I don't have a problem with the foul because a lot of players hit the floor, but that was awfully late.
Yeah. Yeah, I think that she felt like she needed to call the foul when three people go to the floor. I think she felt like she needed to make a call,
yeah.
But she wasn't quite sure who yet.
Teal will look to get it in baseline right with 29 seconds to play first half. Hoffman for three off the glass and in.
Number 20.
37-26 Rochester, 20 seconds to play first half. Holland right side of the floor, gives to Malco with 17. Becky holds with 16, drives in the paint with 15. Her pass kicked away and out of bounds with 14.2 as that was intended for Abbott. But I think that probably Malco probably had a better look at a shot just rising up from about 8 feet.
I agree with you, just inside the TRC logo there.
Stasiak and Murphy back into the game. 14 seconds to play first half. Rochester up by 11. and looking for the final shot of the period. Holland over the defense to Malco. Malco on the right wing, works to the high on the right side.
Looking for Holland.
8 seconds, 7 seconds, gives to Holland with five. Holland left wing, cut off by the defense. Dumped down low to Murphy, tipped out of bounds. They're going to say last touch by Rochester.
Yep, make the call.
Going to last touch by Rochester, so Valley with 4.4 seconds to play in the first half will have the basketball. Teal will get it in with 0.4 to play in the first half. Teal studies, gets it into Hoffman, and that'll do it. At halftime, Rochester leads 37-26. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
At Shepherd Chevrolet Buick in Rochester, it's our customers that come first.
The sales process was very simple, very easy. It's a very nice and friendly atmosphere. They've always worked with me on my trades and what I bought. There wasn't any haggling. It's where I really wanted to be, and I would keep coming back.
Stop out today and let Shepherds help you find your next vehicle.
RTC makes it easy with the new Triple Play Combo. Now you can enjoy the best of cable, internet, and phone for one low package price. Get all of the features that they want at a price you can afford. The Triple Play Combo, another great offer from RTC.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
Back at Rochester High School, we go to the third quarter. The Rochester Lady Zebras up by 11 to 37 to 26, and they'll start with the basketball going to all right. Brett, we just talked briefly to Kathy yesterday, who's obviously running the clock and the scoreboard and all that good stuff. Tuesday night, the Rochester guys are home with Caston, and there really is kind of four basketball games Tuesday night. It's kind of neat. So at 4:30, the freshmen will play, and then between the freshmen and the JV game, the Special Olympics will play.
Yeah.
Is that Special Olympics of Fulton County, you think?
I would guess, yeah.
Okay. And then, obviously, the junior varsity and varsity game will then around 6-ish or so. Again, that's Tuesday night at Caston.
Not here, no, here at Rochester.
That is here. That's what I said.
Against Caston.
Is that what I said?
No, but that's all right.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that is here, I think. Murphy has a shot blocked. Gets it back, puts it up. No good. Rebound. It's by Sechrist, who's back in the game with two fouls. To Teal. Teal splits the defense, throws up a shot over Pollock, it goes.
That's the eighth point by Teal.
And it's 37 to 28. X, right side, gives in the corner to Murph. Lob pass down the little Pollock, wide open jumper, 2 foot in is good. Well, if Sechrist is going to front her, that's what she's going to get.
Yeah. Well, you notice that Tucker was right in Holland's face.
Yeah, right. I'm guessing that's
going to be
one thing they talked about in the locker room. Teal against Pollock. Backs the way in. Throws the ball away. Stasiak picks it up. Goes to the basket. Layup is no good. And we're going to have a foul. Wow. Light foul on Hoffman, who did not touch her.
Yeah, I don't think I agree with that either. I think I was just going to make a comment. I think Stasiak needs to pay more attention to making the layup and less attention into whether she's going to get run into.
So Keaton Stasiak will go to the line to shoot two. For her Lady Zebras, who are up by 11, and looking to push this, actually, well, never mind. One more coming for Stasiak, she misses the first one.
Now both Sechrist and Hoffman have two fouls apiece.
One more coming for Stasiak, the sophomore. Eyes the second one, lets it fly, and this one's good. 40-28, Rochester on top, the Vikings with the basketball. And then X almost picks the pocket of Tucker, knocks it out of bounds, and the student section says, no. That was last touch by Tippecanoe Valley.
Yeah, right in front of them.
So Tippecanoe Valley had 11 turnovers after the first half,
the
first quarter, now only has 13. So they did a very good job in the second quarter cutting down that number.
Yeah.
Tucker loses the handle, gives out the ball, down low to Sechrist. Sechrist against a double team to Teal. Teal drives the baseline, cut off by Pollock. Now the ball, wide open to Tucker. Foul on the shot, so good line to shoot two. King Stasiak picks up foul number three. And Bailey Abbott will come in for her.
Number 20, Keith Stasiak. And the line four, Bailey, shooting two. Number 12, Harris Tucker.
Okay, Tuesday night, the Fulton County Special Olympics will play the Cass County Special Olympics between the freshman and junior varsity game. Of course,
okay.
The freshman will play at 4:30, and then after that game, the Special Olympics will play, and then we'll have the varsity and the junior varsity game. The Tucker hits both free throws and cuts his lead back to 10, and Rochester with the basketball. Here comes a half-court trap by the Lady Vikings. Murphy takes the pass. Got to get rid of it. Finally does the Malco back door. Malco in the paint now. Picks away through traffic. Runs down the loose ball in the corner. Out to Murphy. Now to X. X fakes the three. Inside the three-point line to Murphy. Murphy in the right corner to Malco. Three on the way. Right baseline. No good. Paula makes it out with the rebound, and she has it taken away. Ball loose on the floor. Knocked out of bounds by Rochester. We're going to have a tie-up, and it's going to go to Valley.
If we can do that one.
As both Pollock and Sechrist battling for the basketball. Knocked out of bounds at the same time. Under six to play in the third quarter. Rochester by 10. Valley with the basketball. Teal from the elbow. Jumper good.
Somebody might want to pick her up.
Yeah. That was a wide open shot.
Yeah.
Ran around her man about the 10-second line, and nobody picked her up. Malco high on the left side. Lobs down low to Abbott. Abbott has the pass knocked away. Picked up by Hoffman. Hoffman with the basketball for Valley. Now to Tucker. Tucker across the timeline left. She, too, playing with two personal fouls. Loses the ball. Now the ball in the left corner. Top the key to Teal. Teal at the free throw line. Hesitates. Goes to the basket. Layup. Good.
She just went right around Pollock.
They are giving her all sorts of room.
Yeah.
And now Valley has the Rochester lead. That was 112 down to 6. Okay. And here comes the Valley crowd, as they should. Murph, or make that... Holland, down low to B, layup, good. 5 minutes to play in the third. Teal pushes for Valley down the right side of the floor. Teal, now we're going to have a Tippecanoe New Valley timeout. It'll be a 60. You're listening to High School Girls Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Just as coaches and team players need to have excellent communication skills to win games, so do you when it comes to all of your telecommunication needs. At RTC, they strive to bring you the very latest technology when it comes to telephone, high-speed internet, and cable television. Call them at 223-2191 and ask to speak with one of their knowledgeable, helpful, and local customer service representatives. RTC, local products, local support, local investment.
Peterson Wagoner and Perkins Law Firm was founded in 1965. Ted Wagoner, Andy Perkins, and Rachel Arndt provide high-quality legal services in the areas of estate planning and probate administration, business creation and expansion, commercial litigation, real estate and economic development, as well as family law, guardianships, adoptions, and criminal defense. They're located at 125 East 10th Street, Rochester, by phone 574-223-4292 and on the internet at petersonwagoner.com.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4:56 to play in the third quarter. Rochester's lead is 8, 42-34. I think the last time that Tippecanoe Valley led was...
I don't know if they've ever led.
You're right. I was trying to think back. Rochester scored first, and they tied. Rochester went up 4-2. They tied, and then Rochester went up 8-4, and that was about it.
Yeah, I think you're right.
So Valley, after their timeout, they're down to 3. Has the basketball. Gets it into Ball. Ball against Pollock. Cut off on the block. Outside to Tucker. Back to Ball. Looking down low. Gets it to Teal. Teal back to Ball. 15-footer left side is short. Pollock with the rebound. Gives to Holland. X brings it up the floor. And Coach Stasiak says, hey, let's slow up a little bit. We're up by 8 with 4.5 to play in the third quarter.
It's been kind of a fast-paced basketball game.
Yeah, I would agree with that. And at times, a flurry of points.
Yeah.
And at times, a dead standstill. Malco almost loses the handle. Gives to Pollock. B just about loses it. Back to Malco in the left corner. Runs the baseline. Tries to feed down low to Abbott. Now kicks to X. X inside the arc. Outside to Malco. Three, right wing. Good!
That was a big three-pointer by Becky Malco.
Rochester back by 11 at 45-34. Tucker across the timeline, works to the right side, now accelerates in the paint. She's going to be fouled by Holland on the reach in right about the elbow before the shot.
She is so quick. She not only made the layup, but I think she was headed for the shower before they called the foul.
4:03 to play in the third. Rochester at 45-34. Teal gets it in to Hoffman in the corner. Hoffman in the paint. Cut off by the defense to Ball. So take another 15-footer. Short again. And Pollock with the board. B gives off to Murph. Now to Malco.
Pollock's got to have a double-double.
What is she, how many points?
She's got 16. Bowles nodding his head.
Bowles to Sarah. So the Rochester Sentinel, the sports editor, says yes, indeed. And then Rochester has the ball tipped out of bounds by Teal. It'll stay with the Lady Zebras right in front of the bench.
That's not a popular call.
Not behind us, anyway. No. Which is where the Tippecanoe Valley fans are sitting. Sitting, I should say. X in the paint. Goes to the basket. Layup. Nope. Rebound to the big girl, Seacrest, and she runs herself to Hoffman. Hoffman has a block by Murphy, and out of bounds. Murph playing with three fouls.
Wow, yeah.
Well, yeah, maybe two.
She's got two. But
very easily could have been three, but she got all ball and tipped her out of bounds. And
then the ball almost hit Hoffman coming back.
Yeah,
down,
you're right.
So, yeah.
Lob pass inside to Teal. Teal skies for it, and she is fouled on the play. And I don't know if that's going to be either Abbott or X.
I'm going to guess against Holland. And it is. That's her second.
3:25 to play in the third. 45-34. Rochester on top. Tippecanoe Valley with the basketball baseline right. Ball, jumper. Yep. That was a quick hitter. And the lead is down to 9 for Rochester. Zebras with the basketball going to our right. Holland to Malco. Malco has it tipped away by Teal. Out of bounds. They're going to say last touch off the foot of Becky Malco.
Well, I wasn't so sure she didn't get fouled.
Yeah. I tell you what, you know, you talk about Broyette, and you talk about Tucker, and you talk about Seacrest and Ball, and who's talking about Teal? Good heavens. She has single-handedly kept his team in the game.
Murphy with a steal.
Yep, Murphy down the middle of the floor. High on the right side now. We'll slow up and reset for Rochester. Murph crossover dribble at the elbow. Dumps down low to Pollock. Pollock then is fouled on the entry pass by Ball, and it's going to be out of bounds to Rochester baseline right with 2:52 to play in the third.
That'll be the second on Ball. Yeah, steal for Tippecanoe Valley. She's got 12 points in the game. 6 of them come in the first 5 minutes of the third quarter.
Holland over the top of the defense, gets it inbound to Malco, to Murph, fakes a three, drives in the paint, leaner, nope. And the rebound by Murphy, her putback is no good. Her rebound again, she puts it off the window, and we're going to have a travel.
Yeah.
2:41 to play in the third. Rochester up 45-36. And the Lady Zebras make that Lady Vikings with the basketball. Hoffman quickly up the floor for Tippecanoe Valley, right inside of the court. Cut off in the corner. Got to get rid of it. And the freshman Seacrest kicked it out of bounds. I don't think that pass was intended for her anyway.
No.
But she and Teal were in the area probably too closely, and that's what happened. Rochester going to get it back after a Tippecanoe Valley turnover. And Meredith Broyette will come back into the game for Tippecanoe Valley. And Broyette will replace Ball for the Vikings.
And Abbott's going to have to be aware that that's her assignment defensively.
Yep.
She's going to have to get out on the arc.
Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. 2:30 to play in the third. Rochester up by 9. Murphy, I make that Malco around the defense. Layup is good. Nice little baby hook down low. Puts the Zebras back up by double digits. Tucker, middle of the floor. High on the right side to Hoffman. Hoffman, crossover dribble. Out to Teal. Teal against Abbott. Teal, right side, bounce pass to the baseline to Tucker. Wide open 15-footer is good. I'm talking wide open.
Well, that's Tucker's first field goal of the game, and you saw Holland just letting her go. She wasn't too concerned about her. She hadn't
proved to me.
Might have even been her first shot of the game.
Yeah. Malco in the paint, picks up her dribble, down low to Abbott, and she is fouled on the wrist, but no call. And Seacrest gets the rebound, pushes ahead to Teal. Teal against Murphy. Teal, her shot is blocked, but Murphy going to get on the arm, and that's going to be Murph's second. And send
third.
Teal to the, yep, Murph's third, and send Teal to the line to shoot two.
Zero foul, number 54, Carly
Murphy. So going to the line will be Kaylee Teal, a 5'7" junior, and she'll go there to shoot two. First one on the way is good, and she'll have one more, looking to cut this Rochester lead to 7 as the freshman Alexis Garrison will come into the game for the first time, and Garrison will replace Murphy for the Lady Zebras. Minute 40 to play, third quarter. 100 seconds to go in the third.
It's a minute 40 for the rest of us.
Teal's second one, good again.
And of course, I had to look at the clock to even figure that.
47 to 40, Rochester on top. Here comes a half-court trap by Valley. Heck, DeMalco crosses the timeline, splits the double team in the paint, has it knocked out of bounds by Valley off the leg of Secret, and it'll stay with Rochester with 1:29 to play in the third.
Rochester kind of playing with just the maintained kind of style of ball here in the third quarter. They had the lead at half, and they're just trying to hang on to it.
Holland in the corner.
Valley playing a lot more aggressively.
Yeah, I agree with that. And now we're going to have a foul on Teal as Malco drove to the bucket, or at least to the left side of the floor. And she drove it and was fouled, and it'll be a Rochester out of bounds, baseline left.
And that'll be Teal's second.
Holland looks to get it in. Got to get it in. Does so to Abbott in the corner. She loses the handle. There's a race for it. Tucker picks it up and runs. Tucker bounce passes across the lane to Teal. Her jumper is good. And now Valley within five.
That's 10 points in this quarter for Teal.
Yeah, she is on fire.
16 for the game.
Nobody talking about Miss Teal coming into this game, but they're going to be talking about her after this game.
Yeah,
I can promise you that. A minute to play in the third.
Especially Tony.
Yeah. Rochester up by five. Malco holds. Couple of dribbles. Splits the double team. Pull-up jumper from 10 feet is a high off the glass and good. 48 seconds. Tucker brings it up to four and will cross the timeline to 40. High on the left side, now to Hoffman, three on the way, top of the key is no good. Tucker with a rebound to put back is no good, but X is going to pick up the foul, and that's going to send Tucker to the line for two.
Holland. So now Holland, Stasiak, and Murphy, all with three for the Lady Zebras.
So Stasiak and Murphy will come back in after the first free throw with 34.8 to play in the third quarter. Rochester up by seven. And Tucker at the line for two free throws. First one's no good.
Back in for the Zebras, number 12, Stasiak, at 44.
34.8 to play in the third. At the line is Karis Tucker, a 5'4 sophomore for the Lady Vikings. And she'll have one more looking to cut this lead to six. Second one, no good. Rebound to Stasiak, who gives to Murph.
They're going to be looking for the last shot. Here comes the half-court trap.
Murph across the timeline with 27. Dribbles near the timeline with 25. In the lane now. Leaner off the glass. Nope, too hard. And stripped away by Murphy. She puts it back. No foul. She get no good. Her putback no good, but a foul coming on Tucker. Murphy will go to the line to shoot with 15.3 to play in the third quarter.
Tucker's going to pick up her third foul. Certificate of foul.
Shooting two.
Coming back in is Abbott and Garrison after the first free throw by Murphy. Actually, if Murphy hits both, she's coming out of the game.
Defensive purposes.
Yep. First one by the senior is good as it hangs on the front of the rim and falls through. Stasiak is out. Back in is Abbott. How many fouls does Bailey have?
One.
Trapedi back into the lineup for Tippecanoe New Valley and Tucker to sit. One more coming for Murphy. Looking to push this lead back to nine. Murph ready. Senior's eyes are second one. Lets it go, and it's good again. So Garrison back into the game, and Murphy to come out. Rochester up 51-42 with 15.6 to play in the third quarter. Teal looks to get it in. Does so to Broyette. Broyette back to Teal. Teal will bring it up against Abbott with 10. Teal blocked, fouled on the shot on the floor. She was fouled on the floor by Abbott, and it'll be out of bounds to Valley with 9.1 to play in the third quarter. So Teal will try it again, this time underneath her own basket, baseline left. 9 seconds to play in the third. Teal looking, slaps the basketball, sends things in motion. Teal still looking. Tough pass to handle to Hoffman. Hoffman with six. In the lane, cut off by the defense with three. Gives to Teal with two. Jumper from the baseline is no good, and that'll do it for the third. After three, Rochester leading by nine, 51-42. Back for the fourth quarter after this on 92.1 WROI.
For over a century, Rochester Telephone Company has been connecting our community, family to family, friend to friend, business to business. It is the people of RTC, your friends, your neighbors, who have made the difference. Times may have changed, but our tradition of excellent service still remains in our family of dedicated employees that serve you. RTC, a part of Rochester's past, present, and future.
That's final. Fourth and final quarter we go here at Rochester High School. The Lady Zebras leading 51-42. And as they start the fourth quarter, Rochester will start with the basketball. Rochester has four timeouts, Tippecanoe Valley with three. And Brad, as you're finishing up the third quarter totals there, let's talk about fouls.
For Tippecanoe Valley, Tucker has three, and pretty much everybody else with two. For Rochester, Holland, Stasiak, and Murphy all with three, Abbott with two.
So the officials are talking to the scorers table about whose ball it is. They're Tippecanoe Valley saying it should be our basketball. And Don King, the Rochester score, keeping the scorebook,
got
set up straight. Right on. Rochester starts before the final period of the basketball. Graffiti still in for Tippecanoe Valley. She's guarding Alexa Holland. And the pass is knocked away, but King Stasiak gets it. Malco now pulls it out. Gives the X right side. Fakes the three. Now in the paint. Down low to Pollock. B backs her way in. And throws an elbow.
It's going to be an offensive foul. Pollock got a little frustrated. That's her first foul.
Number 22, B. Pollock. So B missed the foul and a turnover for Rochester, and now Valley will, nope, I guess they're three away from that. Rochester will shoot from here on out because Valley has 17 fouls. No, they don't. Valley will shoot from here on out. Trapini quickly up the floor. Feeds down low to Secrets against Murphy. Walks through the lane. Gives to Hoffman. Pull up jumper. Line drive shot no good. Pollock with the rebound. Now gives to Holland. Holland runs up the floor. Left side of the court for Rochester. 30 seconds gone in the final period. Rochester up by nine. They've been there about the entire game. Murphy on the baseline. Murph studies. Ball above her head. Still studies. Now dribbles to the wing.
See Chris really leaning on Pollock down low. Murphy wanted to throw it to her, but decided against it.
Stasiak, top of the key. Stasiak drives in the paint. Throws up a shot. Foul on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two. Again, she hit the floor hard.
That foul coming against Trapiti.
Taylor Trapiti.
So Keaton Stasiak in the line to shoot two.
Number 12, Keaton.
Looking to push this lead back to double digits. Rochester leading right now at 51-42. Keaton eyes the first one. Lets it fly, and it is good. One more coming for the sophomore. As Rochester back up by 10. Biggest lead, I think, has been 12, and that coming in the second period. Stasiak ready, eyes the second one, lets it fly, good again. 53-42 Rochester, a minute gone in the final period.
Stasiak's been a big asset having her back in the starting lineup.
Boy, you're not kidding. Teal in the corner, top the key to Trapiti. Her three is in and out, no good. Malco with a rebound. Becky runs around Broyette, brings it up the floor behind her back dribble. Now we'll cross the timeline for the Rochester Lady Zebras, who lead by 11. And now we're going to have Teal picking up a foul. That'll be the team's sixth.
So that'll be Teal's third.
Okay. Rochester will also shoot baskets for free throws from here on out.
Teal had 10 points for the Lady Vikings in that third quarter.
Yeah, and they needed it.
Yeah, they did. She's got 16 for the ball game.
Here comes a running jump defense, and she is fouled as Malco by Hoffman. And Malco will go to the line to shoot one of the bonus. So it's time for Rochester to make hay from the line.
Absolutely. And Hoffman will pick up her third.
Now
so now you got Tucker, Hoffman, and Teal all with three for the Lady Vikings. Holland, Stasiak, and Murphy all with three for the Lady Zebras.
Here's what I see. Secrets picked up two fouls early in that first half and has not fouled since for Valley.
Yeah.
Malcolm's free throw no good as Secrets for the board. Rochester by 11. Six and a half to play in the game. Royette against Stasiak. To Trapiti. Steps into a three. It's good.
Valley basket number 10.
And now it's 53-45. Malco against Teal. Gives ahead to Murphy. Murph on the wing, wide open to Stasiak. Keaton, layup is no good, expecting it, anticipating contact, getting none. Threw up the shot too hard. Trapini to Broyette for three, left wing, no good. And the rebound to Teal, out to Hoffman for three. Nope. Rebounded to Broyette. Broyette against Pollock. Her layup is no good. And B with the rebound gives Malco. 53-45. Rochester on top with 5:50 to play in the game. Murphy splits the double team out to Malco. Malco splits the double team in the lane to X. Fakes the three. Now to Murphy, top of the key. Murph against the double team. She splits it as well. Gives out to Holland near the center circle. Now to Malco, high on the left side. Becky, one dribble. A wraparound pass to Holland on the right wing. In the middle to Murphy. Murphy dribbles away from contact. Gives to Holland. And Holland's pass is picked off by Hoffman. Hoffman against Malco. Layup is no good. And the rebound to Sechrist, who's fouled on the shot. She'll go to the line to shoot two.
Well, Pollock picks up her second.
Pretty lazy pass that time.
Yeah, it was.
That was picked off. Trying to make a round-the-corner pass by putting some English on the basketball, and it just kind of laid out there on the floor.
5:14 to play in the game. Sechrist's first free throw is good. She'll have one more.
That's the first point for Sechrist since early in the first quarter.
And she cuts the lead to 7. One more coming for the freshman. 6 foot. Brad, we're going to see a lot of her.
Yeah, we are.
Next couple years. The second one's good again.
At least three more years.
That's why I'm here.
Yeah, I appreciate that, and I asked for it. 53-47. B. Pollock layup is good. A foul.
Wow, I didn't think they were going to call
him. I didn't either. Another late call.
Yeah. They've really been pretty poor about making some of those contact calls down low.
Sechrist picks up foul number 3, and Pollock will go back to the line to shoot 1, looking to push his lead back to 9.
Shooting 1.
Pollock, 1-2 seniors for the Rochester Lady Zebras in the line for 1, looking to complete the 3-point play with 5:04 to play in the basketball game. B sets herself. Fires the first one. Nope, no good. Rebound full four. Murphy comes out of there with it. Layup is no good. And Sechrist has it. Sechrist now to Trapini. Trapini runs for Tipping New Valley. Right side to Hoffman. In the corner to Broyette. Wide open three. Yep.
3 points. Valley basket.
And now the lead of Rochester's is down to 5. And Rochester will use a timeout. It's a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Superior Auto is Rochester's hometown buy here, pay here dealer. At Superior Auto, they realize the financing challenges that exist for hardworking people like you. They have been helping people with credit challenges for over 30 years. With over 48 locations and over 1,000 vehicles to choose from, they find the right car, truck, SUV, or van to fit your needs. And they have down payments as low as $364 in payment plans to fit your budget. With the shortest payment terms in Rochester, push, pull, or drag in your old vehicle for $1,000 minimum trade-in. Stop into Superior Auto and let them get you in the vehicle that is right for you. 302 East 9th Street, Rochester, or online at superior-auto.com.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
4 minutes, 44 seconds of play of the game, and Rochester's lead that was once 11 not very long ago, Brad, is down to 5.
Yeah, I've had a couple. I've got a 3 from Petripedi and from Broyette that really hurt the Lady Z's. They haven't been very productive here in the fourth quarter.
Broyette has hit 2 threes, I believe, in this game. Both of them have been wide open.
Yeah.
Shooting a 3 for Trapini, or for Broyette, is like shooting a free throw. X with the basketball, top of the key, now to Malco. 4.5 to play in the game. Here comes a run and jump defense by Valley, who Holland gives to Malco. She runs through the double team, loses the handle. Murphy picks it up, gives down low to wide open. Pollock, her up jumper is good.
Pollock now with 20 and double digit rebound.
7-point lead for Rochester, and now Hoffman travels. Rochester going to get it back after another Valley turnover. And the Rochester Lady Zebras will trigger it in right in front of the Tippecanoe Valley bench. Leading by 7 and 4:19 to play in the game. Malco, make that Murph, gets it into X. X against Tucker. Right side of the floor. Bounce pass to Murphy, high on the right side. Murph against Broyette. Gets a pick from Pollock. Pick and roll, down low to B. Her jumper's good!
Number 22, B.
That's a perfect pick and roll executed, and Rochester back up by nine. Teal down the floor, jumper no good, rebound to Murphy. Murphy spins away from trouble, now gives to Malco. Malco is fouled by Teal, that's number four. That's going to send Malco to the line for one and the bonus. .350 to play in the game. Rochester, I don't know how, has an opportunity to push us back to double digits.
Yeah, well, it's a physical basketball game. Valley's had a number of fouls called on them here in this fourth quarter, playing from behind. Rochester trying to make just enough of them to keep that lead above five.
I think if Teal fouls out, would be a disaster for Tippecanoe Valley.
I would agree.
She has single-handedly kept this game close. Oh, the free throw way off the mark. Rebound to Teal. Teal runs right side of the floor. Cross-court pass to Broyette. Three on the way for the lefty is short. And the rebound to Tucker. Put back no good, but a foul coming on Rochester. And Tucker will go to the line to shoot two.
And Holland's going to pick up her fourth.
3:40 to play in the game. Rochester up 59-50. Murphy will come back in and X will sit down.
Tucker.
After the first free throw, of course. Karis Tucker, a 5'4 sophomore at the line for two. First one's good. She'll have one more. Trapiti back into the game and Teal to sit. I think that's the first time that Teal's been out of the game the entire night.
You're probably right.
So Tucker with one more for the Lady Vikings, looking to cut this lead back to seven. Second one in, rolls around a couple of times and falls through.
Kind of a quick shot, quick release on that one.
Full court press by Tippecanoe Valley. Malco across the timeline. Malco high on the left side, around the defense, in the paint. Gets it down to B somehow. Her jumper's too hard. Rebound tipped around. Stacey comes out with it to B. B now pulls it out and resets for Rochester. Now to Malco, and now Coach Stasiak will use a 60 timeout. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Coca-Cola Bottling Company of Plymouth wants you to enjoy your world. And now that we're into 2014, basketball, swimming, and wrestling are going strong. The pro football playoffs continue, and the Winter Olympics will be here soon. So there's plenty to do. Whether it's heading for the gym, outdoor activities, or getting together with friends and family, grab the refreshingly clean taste of Coca-Cola, Diet Coke, Coke Zero, Sprite, and Sprite Zero. Make sure you have plenty of Coca-Cola products on hand, either from the store or the vending machine. Coca-Cola products go great with everything you do. It's the real thing. It's Coca-Cola.
It's all in the name, and at All About Pets, it really is all about pets. All About Pets Downtown Rochester is your locally owned pet store that caters to you and your pet. They work hard to bring the very best in pet supplies to our area. Choose from premium pet foods, pet healthcare supplies, toys and treats, small animal food, pet accessories, fish, and aquarium supplies. That's All About Pets, one block north of the courthouse on Main Street in Rochester. Their only business is to enhance the happiness of your pet.
And we're all about pets.
Zebra Basketball. WROI.
3:22 to play in the game. Rochester by 7 at 59-52. And Rochester with the basketball on the far sideline right in front of the student section. After Rochester took a timeout, they're down to two. Murphy's got to get it in. Murphy's got to hurry. And will throw to Malco near the Valley free throw line. Malco loses the handle, but has it back. Gives to Murphy high on the left side. Murphy against the defense. Splits the double team. Has a pass stolen by Broyette. Now Stasiak has it back. And now back to Murphy. Murph, wow. Teal just got away with foul number five.
Yeah, I don't know
why. And now we're
going
to have a foul. Now we're going to have a foul on Teal. Is that going to be five on Teal?
About time. They got to knock him down and on the ground before you get a foul called. And that is five on Teal. She's done. So she'll leave the game with 16. I don't know why they're booing it. I thought she fouled about three times before they called it. Yeah.
Teal is done, and Trapiti will come back into the game. 3:04 to play in the game. Rochester by 7. Trapiti comes back in, and Teal, the lifeline of this team in this game anyway, sits down.
For Valley, she didn't score any points in that fourth quarter, but she finished tonight with 16.
Well, she single-handedly kept Valley in this game in third.
In that third quarter, yeah, she had 10.
Murphy the line for two big ones. First one for the senior is nope, no good. She'll have one more.
Free throws have been a problem for the Lady Z's here in the fourth quarter.
Rochester by 7. They need all the help they can get here with 3 minutes to play in the game.
2 of 6 here in the fourth.
Alexa Holland still on the bench for Rochester. She, too, has 4 fouls. Second one's no good again. And we're going to have a
Off of Abbott.
Yeah, Abbott knocked it out of bounds, and it'll be back to Tippecanoe New Valley. 3:03 to play in the game.
Foul situation where both teams are dead even at 9 and 10, but you wouldn't know that from listening to the crowd.
Rochester by 7. Tucker feeds down low, knocked out of bounds. Going to stay last touch by Abbott. And it'll be out of bounds to Tippecanoe Valley baseline right. And yeah, now you got to look as Teal is out. For Petey and Broyette will be your two biggest threats from behind
right.
the arc.
And they've all been hitting the threes.
Broyette has it in the corner. Broyette against Stasiak. Runs away, runs over Stasiak, and Keaton picks up the blocking foul. That's going to send Broyette to the line to shoot two.
That'll be Stasiak's fourth.
Broyette just did beat her to the line, to the spot. Yeah.
Number 14.
So Keaton has four, and Alexa Holland after the first free throw will come in with four. And Broyette at the line to shoot two for the Lady Vikings. First one for the Southpaw is no good, too hard, too close. X is in, Abbott is out. Brad Thomas, I'm David Musselman. The 2:51 to play in the game.
Coach Stasiak going with his best hand for the rest of the game.
Right him with four.
Yep.
Second one for the freshman, good this time. 6-point lead, close as well. They've been as close as five in this half, has Valley. Here comes the half-court trap, Holland. Around the defense to Malco. Around the double team. And it's going to be called for a... Oh.
Over and back.
What?
I didn't see it. I don't know
over and back? Well, Roger Valley going to get it back down by six with 2:40 to play in the first half. I'm not sure what she was looking at, but that wasn't even close to over and back.
I didn't think so either. I'm sitting right on the midline here.
Tucker works right side against Holland. Top to Hoffman. Hoffman against Malco in the man-to-man defense, and Valley will have a... Has a timeout. It'll be a 30. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
If your vehicle's on the disabled list, then see the service pros at Dagnan Motors.
Are you ready for a great deal? A money-saving party. We got lots of used cars, trucks, and vans. We'll get you kick-started. Our prices and selection are out of sight. Come deal with us. We're going to treat you right.
If your vehicle's sidelined with an injury, call timeout and see the service pros at Gagnon Motors. Their team of expert technicians have the most up-to-date diagnostic equipment, plus the experience to get the job done right the first time. As an AC Delco repair shop, they have the parts and supplies you'll need too. Don't get stuck on the sideline. Stay in the game for every play with the help of Gagnon Motors on State Road 14 in Akron or online at gagnonmotors.net.
We're gonna treat you right.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
2:25 to play in the basketball game. Hoffman with three from the left side is short. Rebound to Murphy, dribbles out of trouble. Rochester up by six. Now X has it. X hesitates.
Across
the timeline, yeah. And Valley in that defense, that run and jump defense, and X picks away through it, dribbling wise.
I say it's supposed to be the new rule this year about the hand check, and the ball handler's been banged up the floor all the way.
B. Pollock strips the ball from behind, and Broyette has it. She steps back for three. No good off the mark and out of bounds. 1:50 to play in the game. Rochester by six, clinging by might add to a 6-point lead.
Right, and it's the free throw line that's different here in the fourth quarter. The Lady Vikings, 5 of 6 from the line. The Lady Zebras, 2 of 7.
Rochester the basketball, 1:45 to play in the game. Malco splits the double team, gives to Holland. Holland the baseline to B, to Malco. Now we're going to have a foul on Broyette. It's going to send Becky Malco to the line to shoot two.
It's two on Broyette.
1:39 to play in regulation. Rochester leading 59-53. And if there's a bigger time to hit a free throw, I'd like to, for you to tell me.
Yeah. Well, Malco's 0 for 2 here from the line in the fourth.
First one for the sophomore, good. That looked good from the let-go. She'll have one more and the lead back to 7, which is more important because that makes it a 3-possession basketball
game. Yep, you're right.
Malco with one more looking to push this lead to 8. Second one, good again. The concentration on Malco was at the top of the scale that time. 1:35 to play in the game. Tucker gives in the corner to Hoffman. Hoffman almost falls out of bounds, and now we're going to have a Valley timeout. It's a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Your Fulton County REMC is proud to offer the new Faster Exceed satellite internet service. They can now connect customers to their fastest satellite internet service ever with broadband speeds up to 12 megabytes per second. For homeowners with fewer options for internet service or who live in rural areas, there's no better option than Exceed Broadband. Share photos remarkably fast. Enjoy better video chat with less jitter. Send and receive files quickly. Exceptionally fast web browsing and email. Listen to streaming music. If you're ready for a faster internet connection, you're ready for Exceed Broadband. Call 574-223-3156 today to learn more about the amazingly fast Exceed Broadband service offered by your local Fulton County REMC, your Touchstone Energy provider.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
A minute 29 to play in regulation. Rochester up 61-53. Tippecanoe New Valley has one timeout left. Rochester has two. And it'll be Vikings basketball on the far side. About elbow height. Rochester, real quick, Brad, foul situation.
For Rochester, Holland with four, Stasiak with four, Pollock two, and Murphy with three. For Tippecanoe Valley, Tucker with three, Hoffman with three, Teal is gone.
Yep,
and Seacrest with three.
Tucker gets the inbound pass from Trapedi. Drives it left, cut off by Hoffman, or make that Holland. To Seacrest, to Hoffman, Hoffman. Outside to Trapedi for three over Pollock. No good. Good block out by Murphy, and she gets the foul on over the back on Seacrest.
That's her fourth.
And Murphy will go to the line to shoot two. Great block out by Carly Murphy with 1:17 to play in the game. And Murphy with an opportunity to stretch this one to back to double digits.
And for the ladies here.
Carly Murphy at the line to shoot two for Rochester. With the Lady Zebras up by eight right now. Murph's first one, good. We'll have one more. Again, Tippecanoe New Valley down to their final timeout. Rochester with two. Murphy with one more, looking to push this lead to 10. Murph ready, eyes the second one, lets her go. No good, too hard. Rebound to Broyette. The freshman runs for Tippecanoe New Valley. Runs away from Rochester. Goes to the rack, no foul, the shot, a lot of contact. Murphy with the rebound. Gives to Holland. Holland then has her ball stripped away by Tucker, and it goes out of bounds on Valley, and it'll go back to Rochester with 64 seconds to play in the game. Man, there was a lot of contact between Broyette and Murphy, and no
Murphy
call.
Could have easily picked up.
Oh, boy. Murph looks to get it in. Does to Holland. Holland across the timeline. Comes from the near side, being chased by Valley. Works to the left side now. Gets a pick from Murphy. Runs away from the defense. Splits the defense to Malco. Malco with the basketball against the double team, and now we're going to have a foul coming against, I believe, Tucker, and that's going to send Malco back in the line to shoot two with 50 seconds to play in the game with Rochester up by nine.
And Tucker now has four.
And shooting two, number 20,
Becky Malco just hit two big ones just moments ago. We'll have two more here. Malco studies, fires, no good, in and out. Rochester looking to push this lead back to double digits with one more from the sophomore, Becky Malco. 50 seconds to play in the game. Malco ready. Eyes the second one. Lets it fly. Good. 63-53. Tucker with the basketball. 48 seconds. Cross the timeline with 46. Tucker gives off to Hoffman. Hoffman around the defense. Outside to Broyette with 40. Broyette looking for some room to shoot. Good job by Malco with 38. Tucker for three. No good. Malco with a rebound with 32. Malco gives to Murphy, and now Stasiak will use another timeout. It's a 60. You're listening to Lady Zebra Basketball, 92.1 WROI.
Statistics show that 99% of all farms are family-owned. If you're a farmer, you want to make certain that you carry on the family tradition by passing it down to the next generation. Make certain that you protect your heritage by talking to your Pekin Insurance Agency, Jennings Insurance in Rochester and Argus. They'll help you create an estate plan for your farm that will treat all heirs equally, even those who don't farm, and have sufficient funds for income, gifts, and estate taxes. You can do all this and more with the right insurance plan from Jennings Insurance, representing Pekin Insurance. Call 574-224-7777 in Rochester and 574-892-5249 in Argus today about carrying on the family legacy for years to come.
Zebra Basketball, WROI.
31 seconds to play in the game. Rochester up by 10. and it'll be Rochester basketball out of after their timeout. We've got a minute to play in the basketball game. It's frustrating to see the fans not showing a whole lot of appreciation for the hard work that
during the timeout. Yeah,
come on. These kids are fighting for their lives. And we're sitting on our hands for crying out loud. Murphy gets it into Stasiak. Keating around the defense. Now ahead to Malco with 27. Malco backs it out behind the timeline to Murphy. Spins away from trouble with 22. Now to Holland with 20. She holds. Holds with 19. Bounce pass to Murphy with 17. Murph, a couple of dribbles in the baseline. Wrap around pass to Pollock. Now back to Malco with 7. Make that 12, I beg your pardon. Malco, a couple of dribbles. Now to Stasiak with 7. Stasiak. The Malco near the timeline with 4. Malco around the defense with 3, and that's going to do it. Rochester's going to go to 3-1 in the conference by defeating the Tippecanoe New Valley Lady Vikings 63-53. Back with postgame after this on 82.1 WROI.